Hi, I'm Jason Quick here from the Rose Garden, where Terry Stotts was just introduced as the 14th head coach in Trailblazers history, and what he said had to be music to Trailblazers fans' ears. Stotts wants to come in, play a fast brand of basketball that is predicated on three-point shooting, lots of passes, freedom for the players, and limited dribbling. He wants to give freedom and kind of loosen the reins. He says that's got the trend now in the NBA where players want their freedom. They want to accentuate their skills, and as a coach, it's his job to loosen the reins yet provide some structure. So I think we'll see a more wide open, freewheeling Blazers next year. Quite a change from the controlling, half-court, methodical play we saw under Nate McMillan. There were no real expectations set. Neil Olshey, the general manager, said he expects the team to get better every day. Terry Stotts said his hope is that the team will be better in April than it is in November. Obviously, I think this team will take its lumps. It's a young team. There's 8 new coming players out of the 15 on the roster, but there are some building blocks. Obviously, LaMarcus Aldridge is going to be the key point. And Stotts said he hopes to use LaMarcus much like the Dallas Mavericks used Dirk Nowitzki. Stotts comes with a reputation as an offensive mind. He's very innovative. He spent the last 4 years in Dallas with the Mavericks and, of course, helped them to win the NBA title in 2011. Spoke to Rick Carlisle today, though, and he says don't just pigeonhole him as an offensive coach. He knows his defense as well. Because as the Mavericks' offensive coordinator, his job was to study film and study other teams' defenses and how they're trying to stop his offense. So he has a very good sense of what goes into making a good defense. And matter of fact, Stotts in his press conference said, look, defense is going to be a priority for us. He comes with the reputation as being a very mild-mannered, even-tempered guy. But even he said, you know, sometimes I lose it. And some players I've talked to, Sharif Abdur-Rahim, who played for him in Atlanta, said he wouldn't consider him a hard coach, but he's fair and he knows when to crack the whip and get on guys. So the only thing left at hand now after a very, very busy summer is to fill out the rest of the coaching staff. Caleb Canales will be on the staff. They have talked, Caleb and Coach Stotts, matter of fact. They revealed that they were on the same flight back from London after interviewing with Paul Allen. And, you know, they seem to have a good working relationship. They just got back from a camp in Las Vegas, and they shared thoughts on the roster and on the vision of how this team should move forward. As for the other assistants, Stotts would not comment on who he's looking at. Steve Clifford, who was a finalist for the Blazers job, former Orlando assistant, has been groomed under the Van Gundys, will be considered, I'm told. And so I think it's very likely that Steve Clifford will be added to the staff. Outside of that, I would look for a coach who has a background as being a point guard in the NBA. Damian Lillard is obviously going to be a very important piece in this puzzle moving forward. And I think they want someone with a point guard background to groom him and know the ins and outs. But again, I think this was an exciting time for Blazer fans. Even though Terry Stotts might not be the sexiest coaching hire and has a, you know, suspect below 500 coaching record, but you had to like what you heard from him tonight. Him saying that we're going to, you know, push the pace, shoot a lot of threes, move the ball, share the ball, and I want to see freedom out there on the court. They might lose, but they might be exciting as well.